But what does India, you think, mean to Kamala Harris, the new vice president of America?
Look, she's Indian. I tell the Indian roots are just when she comes to India, when she was in India, whenever she used to come to India, did she feel restless? Did she say, no, when I'm leaving? Or I'm, you know, I'm rather tired. I don't know what to do. I'm nothing like that. She was very happy when she was in Chennai. She used to go along the beach with my father. She used to go along with my mother to the temples. She used to travel around wherever they took her. When I was there, she used to cook. She used to like a lot of South Indian food, which my sister used to cook and keep it. She used to come and gobble it. So she likes Indian food, but she likes American food also. So what does that make her? Look, the Indian root business is a war-blown business, okay? Look, in fact, somebody will tell me, which Indian language do I write? I can speak Tamil, but I can't write it fast enough.
Right.
I can speak Hindi, but I can't write Hindi. I don't know any other Indian language that I can write or talk. So what does it make? Not an Indian because I don't know any Indian language? Is English an Indian language? I mean, the identity, I mean, this sort of people, you see, that's what she learned from her father, Kamala. And Shamla, don't slot people in what they speak, what they do, what they eat. Not just, eating which doesn't make just, you Indian.
But just out of curiosity, is she able to speak Tamil? Is Kamala able to speak Tamil?
No, she doesn't. My daughter speaks Tamil, but the problem, you know, I'll tell you one thing. My mother, my wife spoke to my daughter from first age when she was a baby, always in Spanish. Now, in my case, I always used to speak her in English. If I had spoken to her in Tamil, probably she would have picked up on the childhood. But unfortunately, I used to speak to her, Sharda, what are you doing? Whereas she used to always speak to her in Spanish, and she picked up. So language is something what the parents speak and what is spoken frequently in house.
Yeah.
Now, Shamla, when she was living alone.
Please
go ahead.
No. You were speaking about Kamala Harris's mother, Shamla, when she was living alone. Just complete that story.
Yeah, she was living alone. And she was going to come in school. And she can't speak to her all the time in Tamil because she has to teach Tamil. But my wife, who was at home, used to teach her Spanish. Shamla was a working scientist. And she was a good one at that. So it becomes very difficult. So I won't classify anybody by what language they speak, what food they eat. Or where they put the roots. I mean, like a tree, where put the roots. Okay.
I still don't know. Yeah, you don't know. You say Kamala Harris is not a tree. Stop discussing her roots. I kind of like that comment. What would concern Kamala Harris about India today? You said her concerns would remain and they would come from a place of principle, whether she articulated it in public or not.
Let me give you a very concrete personal example.
Yeah.
Interfaith marriage. She was a Hindu Brahmin from South India, went to States. He was a Jamaican African, a Christian from Jamaica. That was interfaith, intercaste, every intermarriage, intercountry, interfaith, intercaste. You damn well say any inter, it's inter. In my case, I'm a Hindu male from India. My wife is a Mexican Catholic. So what does that mean? And you come and talk to me and Shamla and say, look, interfaith marriage is bad. She said, what rubbish are you talking? I'm a product of interfaith marriage. You think I'm wrong? So, of course, she'll feel very strongly about it. But she's not going to say, look, I wouldn't mention the government, state governments in India. She will not say, what rubbish are they talking? That she'll now exercise caution. But obviously, as an intelligent human, she'll say, what sort of people are they?
So, you're saying if she reads about what is called love jihad, she can't express an opinion. She can't express an opinion as vice president, but she can certainly tell you in private that she thinks that's nonsense.
Of course, yes, she'll say it's nonsense in private. Look, let me tell you, I won't say that publicly, but I wouldn't be advising some of her colleagues in the Congress. You know, there are two or three US laws which have sanctions on individuals for the traveling to US, etc. If they are found to be in gross violation of human rights. It's called Magnitsky Global Human Rights Act. I mean, I'm not surprised if some of the Congress people say, look, we'll put so-and-so in India, sanction them under that Magnitsky Award, which means that fellow won't be able to go to good states. And as you know, all high functionaries in India have got children studying in states or living in states and what they want to go there. Yeah. If they're banned from going to states forever, they'll think twice about doing something like that. I don't know, they might do that. I'm not putting ideas in their mind, okay?
but the point is that she may think anything as a private citizen. How do you think this will play out? How do you think this will play out from a regime perspective? You know, the concern that Indians had that the Democrats are going to be much more judgmental, because Biden, for example, raised the citizenship legislation in his campaign.
See, then it will work in the regime this way. If there's a strong movement and a bipartisan movement in the Congress to say, look, this is too much, we should do something.
Yeah.
And the matter comes to the vice president or the president, and they ask her opinion. I don't think she'll say, don't do that. Indians are very nice people. They are the saints of the earth. She'll say, I also don't agree with you. Okay?
Yeah.
But fortunately, as the president of the Senate, she has got only the final 50-50 vote. If it is 49-48, and if they ask her, she said, there's nothing for me to do. It's 49-48. The Senate has passed it, so it passes. So it all depends on how it plays out. But if asked her opinion, either in the administration or somebody, I don't think she'll shirk and say, please don't do that.